All right, here we go. I'm working on my harpies, and I'm painting up the wings right now. I thought I'd record this. So, we're going to talk about how to paint wings. Now, this is just one method of painting wings. There's, you know, quite different various ways you can do it. What I'm going for is sort of a textured, stretched look going across all the membranes here. You could also use other techniques to, you know, paint them so they're transparent or any number of effects. Why I'm using this one is because it's fairly quick. It works very, it's fast to do and it's easy, and that's kind of fitting the style that I've chose for the harpies, because I kind of want to get them, you know, done and onto the gaming table. So, first step after painting the flesh is doing the base coat. So I'm using a mix of Vallejo game color charred brown and dark flesh tone, mixed maybe almost 50-50, maybe a little bit more of the charred brown, and very simply painting the wing area. So the next step after that base coat is a highlight layer, and I did that by adding a large amount of my Panzer Aces flesh base to the previous layer, and this is thinned slightly. This is not like how I typically do layering, where it's very thin layers. This is done a little bit thicker, and I switched to a different brush and has an actual tip. And so I'm just trying to paint lines on right now, trying to give them a slight curve. See there? I know it's looking really bad right now, but this is just the first step. We got a lot more to do here. The second and final highlight stage is done by adding some highlights flesh. And again, this is not layering here, as I've shown repeatedly in the past. This is more like stark contrast with paint that's just barely been thinned. So this is going to go over the previous lines and try to concentrate, you know, so it's on the lines, you know, a little bit towards the top. Don't completely cover the previous line. And again, this is looking very rough right now, but don't worry, because we are going to fix this. So now we come to the stage where we fix the crappiness of those previous two layers. What I have here is a mix of flesh and brown ink, and it's basically straight out of the bottle. This is not thinned at all. Well, I added one drop to about 10 drops of ink, but it's virtually, you know, straight out of the bottle. And basically what this is putting a thick translucent layer over that previous layer, and it really helps to hide a lot of the, well, I would say hide a lot of the detail, but also hides a lot of your mistakes. And if you're looking to paint fast, or, you know, you just want to do a dry brush wash effect on your miniatures, instead of washing and then dry brushing, try dry brushing and then put on a really thick wash after you dry brush, because that'll help, you know, hide some of the roughness that you get from the dry brushing. So this is basically, the reason why I was showing you how to paint wings is because you can use a very thick ink wash to hide very poor work. So on the final step now, I've added a good amount of black ink to my previous ink mixture, and that previous layer is dry. And one second, I need to get a better brush here. There we go. So the previous layer is dry. So now, with the black ink, I'm gonna add a bit of shade. And here's a quick tip on painting the direction you're using your brush in. So since I'm doing this texture along this way on the wing, that's how I want to keep all my brush strokes. So by painting the shadows in the same direction, that helps, you know, keeps that textured effect going. If I went across, well then, you know, I'm fighting that direction, I could end up with like a brush stroke going along this way, which ruins the effect. So, trying to get this in between the highlighted areas placed previously. But this is a rough, you know, quick paint job, so I'm not being extremely cautious here. So if you want to go further in to that center section, you can. We want to darken it a bit. But so that's about it. After this layer dries, I may do one more. Whoops. See, I was talking, wasn't paying attention to what I was doing. I just did exactly what I said not to do. Got some water to try to brush this away here. Anyway, so once I'm done with this, I'm going to let this dry, and then I'll probably go back over again with the straight black ink, very thick, and just do that just in the recesses, just for a little bit of extra punch. And here we are, the finished wings. Now the only thing left to do is paint the rest of the figure. But fortunately for you, here are some harpies that I finished earlier using the same technique. Now, this video is about painting wings. Mainly, though, what I wanted to show you was some of the techniques used. And as I said before, I mean, I wasn't going for super high quality precision painting with this. I was just trying to get something done. And I wanted to show you that painting rough, you know, you can still make things look good. A thick layer of ink, you know, hides a lot of mistakes. And so there's that. You can use that effect, you know, that technique to, you know, cover up some of your blemishes if you're not perfect with a brush. Also, it's a good example of painting direction, what direction you want to go with the paintbrush. In this case, you know, you want to go with, you're trying to create brush strokes, basically, or lines, so when you're painting, you want to go with those lines, not against them. And I'll probably bring that up in a couple other videos and show different examples of that again. But it's quick, it's easy to do, didn't take too long, apart from the waiting for the ink to dry. And you could probably use this for effects on any, well, a wide variety of effects, like a wood grain, you could do the same thing, or you could probably do this on some sort of like demon skin, perhaps, you know, so it has some like muscle tone underneath the flesh. But there you are. So quick and easy way to paint wings or anything you want a bit of texture on. And it doesn't take a extreme steady hand to do it. Anybody can do this.